Hey there, Nation. Welcome to the show. We help you to play miniatures wargaming on a budget. It is I, Commander CheapSkate, and welcome to our very first episode of the Kill Team Chronicles. So this is a series of our hobby side videos. It's going to be like a little offshoot, just like how we did a Brush with Death, the same thing with Ride the Lightning, where we're showing you the update that we're performing on armies that we're painting for our various wargames. This one, the Kill Team Chronicles, is dedicated to my brand new 40k army that I'm using for 8th edition, and that is 1,000 points worth of Deathwatch. The reason why I decided to switch it up is a couple reasons. One, I was getting kind of bored playing with Imperial Guard all the time, and you know, I wanted to play something different, and I've been watching a lot of YouTube lately, especially when it comes to mini wargaming with their Apothis narrative campaign with Deathwatch, and also watching, you know, reading Deathwatch novels and stuff like that, listening to audiobooks on YouTube, and it just kind of just caught my imagination, this idea of this specialized special forces version of the Space Marines. It's something like one every 1,000 humans has what it takes to be a Space Marine, and one every 1,000 Space Marine has what it takes to be a member of the Deathwatch. And so that's what I decided to do for my army on this one. So as you can see, it's 1,000 points worth of Deathwatch forces, and pretty much the idea is that this army is based off of Watch Company Tertius is the name of the company. I believe it's from I'm kind of going a little bit narrative with it. It's the company that Watch Captain Artemis is the commander of, and so that's how I kind of went about creating this the unit. It's a combination of both the Start Collecting Deathwatch box as well as the Deathwatch Overkill figurines. I start off with that one as well to kind of create this army, and that's what it looks like at 1,000 points. Hopefully I'll be able to build up to 1,000 points later on as time goes on, but for right now we just got to start off with the original 1,000. So first of all, let's go and talk about my HQ choices. First of all, I got Watch Captain Artemis. He's the leader of the group because, you know, he's just pretty awesome as well. At the same time, I also have Chaplain Cassius from the Death Watch Overkill, so very cool character, Ultramarine Chaplain turned Death Watch member as he goes there for a little while. Also right next to him, of course, I have my Librarian. This is the Epistolary Gaius is his name. He's a Librarian with a bolt pistol as well as a force sword, so he's kind of like in there as well. This kind of makes it the headquarters of the Tertius company for Death Watch. Right in the back for my elite force, of course, I have Nihilus. That's my venerable dreadnought. He's armed with twin last cannons. He's got a close combat weapon as well as a heavy flamer as well, and that makes up both my HQ as well as my elite choices for this army that I'm building up. After that, of course, we have all four death squads, or kill teams rather. So this is the very first team right here. This one is called Kill Team Zakeon. Is what it's called because it's led by Sergeant Zakeon. He's a disciple of Caliban. He's over the power sword as well as plasma pistol. I got two Death Watch veterans, one with twin power swords. Another guy's got a chainsaw and a bolter as well. In the very back, I have my black shield armed with a thunder hammer, and that pretty much makes it my very first kill team that I have here. Also, right after them, of course, is my next guy. That's Kill Team Cruel is what it's called. It's led by Sergeant Cruel. He's of the Flesh Terrors, which is called Chapter. That's where he's from. And also, he's got a bolt gun and power sword. He's got two Death Watch veterans. Those guys are armed with stalker pattern bolt guns. And he's also got two more Death Watch veterans armed with frag cannons to create that. So that's kind of like my suppressive element, while these guys are more like my assaulters. The third kill team that I have lined up next is right over here too. It's also another five-man squad. It's called Kill Team Dothros is what it's called. It's led by Sergeant Dothros of the Minotaur's Chapter of Space Marines as well. He's also packing a Common Melta as well as a Storm Shield. I got two veterans with Common Meltas and Power Swords. And then, of course, I got a Furnace Heavy Bolter in the back. And I also got one Death Watch Terminator, Armored Heavy Flamer, and Melta Power Fist as well. So this is like another little miniature, little assault squad, suppression squad that I have. These guys have all the special weapons and Meltas and stuff to deliver some of my high-strength attacks. And the very last kill team that I have is another five-man team. It's called Kill Team Tol'Dorax. It's led by Sergeant Tol'Dorax. He's a Knight of the Raven. That's this guy here. He's armed with a shotgun. And of course, I got two Death Watch Vanguard veterans. One guy's armed with a chain sword and a hand flamer. The other guy's got twin lightning claws. And then, of course, I got my Death Watch biker. That guy's got twin link bolt guns, a power sword, as well as a storm shield. And then also I got one black shield as well. That's this guy here in the bottom. He's armed with a power maul as well as a storm shield. So another assault squad. So as you can see, I pretty much kind of line up my company with two assault squads. That says Kill Team Zakeon, as well as Kill Team Tal'Dorei as well, which is over here on this side. And of course, I got my two suppressive elements, one armed with flamers and multi-guns, the other one just armed with long-range firepower. And of course, I got my elite choice for my veteran, my venerable dreadnought, as well as my HQ choices as well. So yeah, we're going to be using this army a lot for my Longest War series of Warhammer 40k battle reports. I'm also be doing update videos as we assemble this unit, as well as paint it up as well. We're going to start off with 1,000 points, get that fully painted up, and then if my friends want to continue going even deeper with Warhammer 40k, maybe I might up into a 2,000 point army, you know, maybe get some Korax Black Stars, which would be kind of cool as well. But, you know, it's all up in the open right now. But anyways, that's good to do for this one, ladies and gentlemen. As always, please feel free to like, comment, and or subscribe. Your guys' input is invaluable as always. Also, check us out on Google+, Facebook, Instagram, and blogger.com for all the latest and greatest what we're doing for our hobby. That's good to do for this one for the Kill Team Chronicles. We will see you guys in the next one. You guys stay classy.